I welcome you all, my dear students. Today's video on integrated circuits, ICs of unit 4, electronics components and signals from subject basic electrical and electronics engineering from mechanical 3I. Now these are the course outcomes. After watching this video, you are able to get the concept of integrated circuits, what are the advantages and disadvantages of integrated circuits. You are able to know the classification of integrated circuits, and then you can able to differentiate the analog and digital ICs or integrated circuits. What are the integrated circuits? Integrated circuits consisting of the number of various components like resistor, capacitor, diode and transistor, which are fabricated on a single small silicon chip or silicon wafer. So integrated circuit consists number of circuit components like transistor, diode, resistor and the interconnection in the small single package to perform a complete electronic function. These components are formed and connected within a small chip of semiconductor material. So on the semiconductor wafer or silicon chip, all number of components and their interconnection are fabricated on a single silicon chip. So students, have you seen the integrated circuits? So these are the integrated circuits. You may have been seen in the laptop, in the mobile. So there is no any electronics device or device and appliances without the IC. So almost all the electronics devices, appliances like TVs, computers, laptop, mobiles, DVD player, routers, everywhere there is the use of integrated circuits. Now, what are the advantages of integrated circuits? In a small IC integrated circuit, there are various small reduced size of electronics components. So first advantage of integrated circuit is small in size due to the reduced device dimension. Second one is because of very small size, weight of the IC is very low weight due because of small size. Third one is low power requirement due to the lower dimension and lower threshold power requirement. Next one is low cost due to large scale production. Next advantage, high reliability due to absence of solder joint. Next point is increase the response time and speed. Next one, easy replacement instead of repairing, as it is economical. Instead of repairing, we can replace IC in the circuit. Higher yield because of batch production. So these are the advantages of integrated circuits or ICs. Now disadvantages of integrated circuits. If any component in the IC goes out of order, so whole IC has to be replaced by new one. So if there is any fault or if any component in the IC has damage, so we have to replace complete IC by new one. So second one is it is not economical to fabricate the capacitance exceeding 30 picofarad. So in IC, it is not economical to fabricate the capacitance exceeding 30 picofarad. It is not possible to fabricate inductors and transformer on the surface of semiconductor chip. So it is very difficult or it is impossible to fabricate the transformer and inductors on the IC. Then it is not possible to produce the high power ICs, and there is a lack of flexibility in IC. So these are the disadvantages of integrated circuits. Now classification of IC. So ICs are classified into main four types, classification based on the active devices. So which active devices use, according to that this is a classification: bipolar IC or unipolar IC. In bipolar IC there is a use of transistor, and in unipolar IC there is the use of MOSFET. Now according to the classification based on the application, for there are again two types: linear or analog ICs, or digital or non-linear ICs. So for based on the application, whether it is used for any analog application and for whether for use for a digital application, there are two types. So next, classification based on the technology, which technology has been used, whether monolithic technology used for the fabrication, or whether hybrid technology used for the fabrication. In monolithic, again there are two types: bipolar ICs and unipolar ICs. And last one, the classification based on the number of transistors or number of active devices. Active devices may be MOSFET or may be BJT or transistor. So according to that, there are types: SSI means what, small scale integration; MSI means what, medium scale integration; LSI means what, large scale integration; and VLSI means what, very large scale integration. So in small scale integration, number of transistors are 10 to less than 100. In a single IC there are the 10 to less than 100 transistors in the small scale integration. In medium scale, number of transistor will increase than SSI. In very large scale, number of transistor will increase than MSI, and then very large scale, number of transistor will increase than LSI. So in medium scale integration, there are the transistor from 100 to 10,000 transistors can be used in the single IC. In large scale integration, 1,000 to 1 lakh transistor can be used in a single IC, and in very large scale integration, 1 lakhs to 20 lakhs transistors can be used in a single IC. So this is the classification according to the number of transistor integrated in the IC or integrated circuits. Now this is very important topic which may ask in examination: differentiate analog and digital IC. So analog IC means what, input and output is output of analog IC is analog, output of digital IC is digital. So signal characteristics, first point is here, signal characteristics: signal is continuous. Analog means what, amplitude of an analog signal changes or varies with time, it's called analog signal. And digital means what, in digital signal, amplitude or signal having the only two values, high value or low value, or 0 or 1. So signal characteristic is continuous in case of analog IC. In digital IC it is discrete or digital, 0 and 1. Technical complexity: high entry barrier with a 10 to 15 years learning curve. And in digital IC, relying on the computer aided design CAD tool with a 3 to 5 years learning curve. Product accreditation more than 1 year, and for the digital 3 to 6 months. Substitutions is low for analog IC, it is high for the digital IC. Product portfolio: low volume, high variety. For digital IC, high volume and low variety. Applications: power management, audio amplification, signal transformation and monitoring. While digital IC is used mostly in the digital computation, logic computation, then control digital signal coding and decoding. Price for the analog IC is stable, it is volatile for the digital IC. So this is about the distinguish between analog and digital ICs. So now questions, assignment question on the on this integrated circuits topics. What is analog integrated circuit IC? Integrated circuits. List any four advantages and disadvantages of integrated circuits. Second, next question is differentiate analog IC and digital IC. Third question is classify integrated circuits. So these are the three questions related on the integrated circuit topic. So students, this is only for this video. And from this topic, we have completed our first unit, fourth unit, which is electronics component and signals.